Joining us today on Deserwood Days, and I am your host, Kathy Blaze. Today we are here with the talented Adrian Trice, one of our local business owners here in Arizona. And today she's going to give us some tips as entertainers on how to prepare your tax and make sure you're catching everything throughout the year. Welcome, Adrian.
Thank you for having me. It's such a privilege to be here.
Such a pleasure to have you, lovely lady. So, Adrian, first, I'm going to be a little nosy with you here.
Okay.
You know what? Because I remember going to school and getting my degree and everything. And I tell you, the financial stuff and all the accounting, that wasn't for me.
Right.
I know. And it's not for everyone. But, you know, there's those students that just loved it. So how did you get into the financial industry?
So that's a good question because I didn't major in finance. I'm a marketing major. Okay. So I love PR, marketing, positioning. But when I entered this corporate sector, I took a position in sales and finance.
Okay.
And it was tied to taxes. So I really just took to it. And it just happened to be one of those things that put me into a position to own my own business.
Congratulations. That's awesome. But you know what? I think when we say that, I think it's more of tedious.
Absolutely.
And a lot of people don't understand certain things, but we really do it every day in our daily lives.
Absolutely.
When it comes to running our households. I mean,
absolutely.
we're our household accountants.
Yeah, we have our own personal economic system, and yeah, we use it every day.
Yes. When you're not working in the financial industry, what would we find Adrian doing?
So yesterday I came back from Sedona and feeling refreshed. I love the hike. And then I just recently signed up for a golfing clinic just to do some networking with other women mine in the valley. So I'll be golfing for the next few weeks. So those are just some things because, as you mentioned, taxes is really tedious. So I just need to create outlets and have an identity outside of my business.
Right. And it's one of those niches that it affects everyone.
Absolutely.
Not just a certain group of people. This is something, your services is utilized by everyone.
Absolutely. Yes.
That is awesome. So how was the golfing?
Nice. I used to do it when I was younger. And so I'm just like trying to get back to, you know, things that bring joy. And taxes is definitely a wonderful industry, but just being able to get out, and we're in Arizona.
Right.
The perfect weather. So while my family in the Midwest is back home buttoning up, I'm out here on the golf.
Where are you originally from?
I grew up outside of Chicago.
Okay.
I'm a small town Midwest girl.
Okay. Well, welcome to Arizona. How long you been out here?
I'm pretty much a native. This is home for me. It's 23 years.
Oh, yeah. You're one of us, girl.
I'm 23 years. All my kids, I have two kids who graduated from high school from here. So, yeah, this is home.
Yes. You're one of us now. We're going to keep you.
Yes.
As a tax preparer, what are some of the biggest mistakes you see some of us making?
I would say maybe not keeping track of things that are expenses. So definitely, even if you're doing something such as acting and you're doing a lot of independent contract work, making sure that all of the expenses are accounted for.
Right.
Driving to those auditions could be, you know,
that is one of my weakest links right there, is keeping track of my mileage. And I know there's an app for everything.
Yes. Meals, say if you're out and networking, meals are definitely important. And then also any type of acting classes, personal development, books that you're reading specifically to help you progress your art. So those are things that you can definitely capture. And some people forget, you know, they're so caught up in just, you know, mastering the craft.
Right.
And then another thing that I found is really look at yourself as a business owner, even though you have the
Right.
independent contract, like you
Right.
are like building an
This is, yeah,
empire.
that's your
Walk
business.
like that.
Right.
And
Right.
like when you do that, everything else falls together. So when people
Yeah.
come to me, they're like, oh, I'm just doing a checklist. No, let's go ahead and build you.
Yeah.
Tax supports that, but
Get
build
rid of that word
you.
just.
Oh, yes. No, like build you, right?
Yes.
Absolutely look at yourself differently and go out there and slay. So I
Yeah.
think when folks come in to me, yeah, I'll help you with your taxes. That's the tedious stuff. But what else we got? What are you gonna, how are we gonna
Right.
look next year when you sit in my chair, we have this conversation? I love to see people progress.
Yes, I love that. I love that. So, do you find yourself with recurrent clients because of that reason, helping them to grow to that next year?
Absolutely. Yes. I've been in my own brick and mortar for 5 years. But I've been in the industry. This would be my 10th season coming
Wow.
up. So yes, I love that relationship. And then I also love to see, clients feel like more like family, see generational folks just elevate. So yeah, I do retain clients based on the
And you
relationship.
know what? And I totally believe that because my tax accountant that I had, I probably was with him probably for about 15 years, and he used to go to his home, and that's where he worked out of his home. And then after change of life, he ended up going into a brick and mortar with a partner. And then he continued to be my accountant. Then he retired. Then his partner took over his clients.
Right.
So I've been with the same organization for all that time.
It is. I mean, like there's clients I've seen, generational clients, which is always fun. I
Yes.
have mom, dad, and grandchild.
Yes.
So we're able to just work together and just make sure that they get those things done.
So with you pretty much taking care of others, because that's what you do in your job, is taking care of others. You doing golfing or whatever other things you do, you need that for your own mental.
Absolutely. And that's what I also encourage as well. Yeah, just like a lot of self-care. We have these occupations, the callings that we fall into, but I'm always encouraging folks to just take a break,
Right.
regroup, and then
Right.
come back and do what we do best.
What are some of the things you recommend for self-care for your clients or for anyone?
I am a huge meditator. Not only do I have a business, but it's a family-owned and operated business. So I have my 23-year-old and my 21-year-old working in it. And of course, like I have an entire team. And so that can be a lot of pressure because we
Right.
have to produce,
Right.
revenue, and these are livelihoods that are close to me.
And you set
So
an example for those young ones.
absolutely. So one of the things that I always allow myself to do in this meditation is to step away and allow myself to release expectations from the external world. And in those moments, it's just about me and healing me. And, like if I have some self narratives that I need to correct, I use that time to also do that. And that's also a time to step back into my greatness and then go out into the world and do what I need to do for the rest of the day.
That is wonderful to hear. So we were talking about self-care, and self-care is so important to being able to visualize your present and your future. Because I think we get so overwhelmed in today's things that we're not able to relax and to think of where we really want to be in our lives.
Yes.
So I agree with your saying. So I would like to also ask you, what are a couple of tools you could offer an entertainer to prepare for doing their annual taxes?
So as we were speaking before, just really walking in alignment with like looking at yourself as maybe like more of a business. So I always like to say, have a bookkeeping system. And I'm not sponsored by these folks, but QuickBooks seems to be the most popular. FreshBooks is an amazing way to just keep track of all of those expenses. And if those things are not easy to use, because you have spectrums of how people feel comfortable,
Right.
an Excel spreadsheet That would be perfect. Or even just writing it down. And
Right.
then when you work with the right tax practitioner, they're going to just take what you write down and then we'll make progress and say, hey, let's try an Excel spreadsheet. And then if you like more of an app, then kind of educate you on how to use those things. So whatever makes you feel more comfortable in your tracking system, just have
Right.
one in place.
Right. And what would you tell those that the majority of the time, you know, even with COVID, we started working in our homes, and that they're entrepreneurs or business owners, they work out of their homes. What advice would you give those people for working in their home, utilizing their home as a as part of their business?
So as long as you have like a designated space, you can actually write off a portion of maybe that office area. And if you do any type of repairs or upgrades in that office area, definitely keep track of those. I always like to say, I use the term alignment. So if you are building an empire, you can always trademark your name, get an LLC, have an EIN number, right? Start rocking and rolling, and then open up a bank account with that. And then just use your card. And, you know, if you're getting paid like an independent contractor under that name, put all of that stuff in that bank account. And then anytime you're out doing business, representing yourself, swipe that card. And a lot of times, those things can be exported into your Excel spreadsheets. Or you'll have just a permanent tracking record that you don't even have to think about, just put it on your card.
And I always ask this because you know what, everyone isn't technically applicable. So
Right.
what, explain to them what a spreadsheet is. Does everyone don't know what a spreadsheet is?
So, Microsoft Office has several different applications. Like, usually, if you're in school, you use Microsoft Word, right? And so, there's another application. It's like an Excel spreadsheet, and it's really tedious. It keeps track of numbers, but in a very simple way, you can have your categories and then how much you spend every single month on those. And then if you type those in, you can just send them over to your tax professional. And if you cannot do that, get a tax professional that's willing to invest in that education. Put it on a piece of paper. Let's not make it complex. The whole thing is, when you are talented, you're supposed to do what you're supposed to do. I work with several artists, and then I'm supposed to do what I'm supposed to do. And so I'm acting on your behalf. So just bring me your stuff and we'll just take it step by step and organize. But it's not to overwhelm the client. It's just to get them out there doing what they're meant to do here in this
And again,
world.
it and again, when they come to a person like you, it's all about trust.
Right,
So they have to
absolutely.
trust that you're going to do what you're supposed to do as a professional.
Right.
So, what is something that you've seen before that you would, I don't know if you can say it, you would recommend as a consumer not to do when it comes to preparing their taxes?
Some of the things I would say not to do, once you actually establish yourself and you have an account, you want to make sure that you don't commingle funds. And that does take time, right? You know, so once you have an established business account, then you go into the mode of maybe paying yourself. And so you don't want to commingle funds. You want to keep all your business stuff with your business stuff and your personal stuff with your personal stuff. And it takes time. It's like creating behaviors along the way. So it's just, you know,
But that's where you come in to help
right.
them to understand what to do or not to do.
Absolutely. And where they're at in their business and their career.
See, I love what you're saying. You're not just a tax preparer. I
Yeah,
mean,
absolutely.
you're there for them through it all, helping them with this. It's almost like helping manage their finances, what you're doing.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome. So is what's up? What's next for Adrian Trice?
So, one of the tax deadlines ended on the 15th of this month. We are still taking clients until the IRS does their soft shutdown to reboot. But right now, we're just preparing for next year. We didn't get much of a break. And then I'm doing a series of ebooks that I'm going to re-release, update. I already have one in place. So I'm going to update it based on the upcoming years of tax se for tax season. and just release that so folks can know what they can write off.
And you know what? And there may not be much difference, but you know what? It probably wouldn't even be so bad. I'm hint, hint, to even create one specifically for entertainers.
I would love to do that. I love customizing things so people can actually see themselves in the process.
Yes. Yes. It was such a pleasure to have you. Where can our audience find you?
So I put all of my information on my Instagram at @TheAdrianTrice.
Okay.
And then all my links to everywhere else to find me. But if you Google The Adrian Trice, go to YouTube, The Adrian Trice, I'm there.
There you are.
Yep.
In that beautiful face.
Thank you.
Thank you. It was such a pleasure having you here today.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. And we thank you for joining us here at Desertwood Days, and we will catch you next time.